back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. A lot of you guys actually may be new here because you just are thinking of going to Belmont University and you want to know what it's like. So if that's you and you're here for the first time, welcome. Come check around, maybe subscribe if you feel like it. So today's video is a pro and con of Belmont University, or if you're not looking specifically at Belmont, you can kind of apply this to just a smaller private university, because that's what Belmont is. If you are new here, then I am a freshman at Belmont University. Right now my major is entrepreneurship, but I'm thinking of adding a double major of marketing. And so I'm in the business college, so I don't go here for music, which is what Belmont is really known for. We'll get into that, but I basically wanted to tell you guys my experience at Belmont, what I liked, what I didn't like, what maybe you will or will not like coming here, and just give you like a student's perspective of the school. So I have my pros and cons, and I'll also just be touching on some questions I've gotten in DMs, that kind of thing. So let's go ahead and get started. We're gonna start with the pros. So my first pro is the campus. If you've never been to Belmont, then you may not know what I'm talking about, but basically Belmont's campus is pristine and very well kept, beautiful buildings. They pay a lot of attention and they pay a lot of money to keeping it this way and the architecture, but honestly, it works. It really got me here. I knew I wanted to go to a school in Tennessee. I'm from Tennessee. Looking in Nashville, I actually compared Belmont and Lipscomb, and one of the main reasons I chose Belmont over Lipscomb, in case you're looking at both schools, is because of the campus and just the pristineness, the luxury feeling of the buildings and the campus. Not saying that there aren't some classrooms that are more old, but for the most part, a lot of the buildings are new, a lot of the buildings are well kept, the lawn, the landscaping is always beautiful. The next pro is the location. It is located right in the heart of Nashville, Tennessee. You can walk to Vanderbilt, you can walk to Music Row, you can walk to 12 South. A lot of the big like touristy places in Nashville you can walk to, or it's a very quick drive or Uber. This being said, if you're trying to get to the other parts of Nashville besides the places I just mentioned, you will need a car or an Uber. There is not good public transportation, so I recommend if you can bring your car, to bring your car, and there's free parking for freshmen even. So that is also another little added in pro if you're thinking about that. So yeah, I do love having my car because I drive a lot of places. Nashville is very fun. It's such a big and growing city. There's always something to do on the weekends. There's always new restaurants, always new stores popping up. Things to do, like even just 30 minutes away, you can go for hikes, you can go in the lakes, which I haven't been to either of those since I've lived here because I have that back home. So yeah, that kind of goes into my next pro, which is the fact that coming here, I thought that most of the students here would be from Tennessee or the South. And while there are a lot of in-state students like myself, there are way more out-of-state students. I'm gonna try to put up the statistics of like in-state to out-of-state, and a lot of them are from the North and the West Coast, which is just, you know, really cool to have different people than I had, you know, back home. So great diversity in that aspect of location. There is a good acceptance rate. Again, I'll try to put the statistic on the screen. So it feels like more of a prestigious school, but really they have good acceptance rates. You have a good chance of getting in if you're just like a good, well-rounded student, like how it is with most colleges. So I really appreciated that. It is fairly small, but it's not too small. I think it's the perfect size for me. There's about 8,000 undergrads, about 8,000 students, about 2,000 freshmen. So way bigger than my little tiny private high school back at home. But it still feels like you know people and you know your professors. Usually there's not more than 35 people in a classroom. And for me, I really wanted that intimacy because that's what I thrived in my high school, was knowing my teachers well, knowing my other students. And so I've really enjoyed the fact that I can be walking across campus and probably recognize someone even as a freshman. You don't have to be a senior to kind of like know people. And so I'm sure by the time I'm a senior, I'll know a lot more people, but as of now, like, you'll recognize people on campus very frequently, and it's just a really great community aspect. I've also had a good experience with almost all my teachers. Obviously some I like more than others, but for the most part, all my teachers have really like had the passion, and they make sure that they definitely act like they want to be here, if that makes sense. Belmont did a phenomenal job with their orientation and welcome week. I compared this to a lot of my friends who went to college, and it was just way smoother, way more welcoming than a lot of other situations I've heard. I think I talked about this in a vlog or like a video, a college video I did after my first semester. They just had a great way to transition you from the summer into Belmont. Yeah, their program is awesome. You get, basically you get put with a group of students that you're gonna have at least one class with all those students. So your first day of classes, you're at least have some recognizable faces in one of your classes. And then you get put with an upperclassman leader, so you get to know them. So it's like you have another friend on campus, someone you can text anytime if you have a question, along with your RA. So this doesn't include your RAs. Those are totally separate people. These are called TT leaders, and you basically spend a few days with this group and with this leader, learning about Belmont, figuring out your classes, where to walk to, figuring out the cafeteria, like just figuring everything out your first few days here. You're with these people, so it's very comfortable. And then actual move-in was so good. I'm gonna miss it next year. It's move-in day, guys. Oh my gosh. Like, so many emotions happen on this day. Basically, they get the TT leaders and a bunch of other student volunteers. You drive up to Belmont. I got out of my car. I told them my name. They started screaming my name. They're like, hey, welcome, Hannah. It's kind of intimidating if you don't like crowds, but they basically rush you upstairs to your dorm. And while you're being brought up the stairs, like, they are bringing up all your stuff. And basically by the time I got into this room, all my stuff was already in here. So you don't lift a finger on move-in. Okay, shout out to Belmont for being so quick to just move everything.
18 seconds, loading us in. Awesome.
They thought I was a student here.
They thought Wes was a student, that's funny. And they bring it all up, you sign a paper, and then you're good to go to set up your room. So very great job with that, Belmont. Like, I'm gonna continue raving about the freshman move-in experience. It was pristine, okay. I also find they give a lot of outside resources. So especially the business college, there's always something. Like yesterday there was a entrepreneur business pitch competition. There are always like entrepreneurs, like not teachers, but entrepreneurs on campus you can talk to, schedule a meeting with. The business college, just because I'm in their email, so I'm not in an email with another college, I'm sure they do it too. But with the business college, they bring in tons of guest speakers, they bring in panels, job fairs, people to help you with your resume. There's always help and events for you in college, whether it's your own business, whether it's just getting a job after college. Like, there's always helpful events. And even if you're not in the business college, you can attend a lot of these, just like I can attend a lot of music events, that kind of thing. Okay, so now I'm gonna get onto the cons. First con, obviously it is very expensive for a school. I don't know if tuition needs to be as much as it is. I definitely understand, because of how nice the school is, that's probably why tuition is so high. But it's just something you kind of have to weigh for you. It's all a personal thing. Like, depends on your financial aid, although I don't think they give enough scholarships either. I think they should give out more money than they do, but you have to weigh that. You have to weigh if you're like your loan interest rate, what your degree is, like if you're gonna be able to pay off these loans in a good amount of time after college, or if you're going into a career where it's gonna be harder to pay off these loans. Like, that it's obviously all just personal, but do take it into in fact that it is a very expensive school, even though it is less than obviously Vanderbilt, and we're right next to Vanderbilt, so you're kind of getting a similar Nashville experience with a lot less than the price of Vandy, but it still is expensive. Since it is a smaller school, they don't have every degree under the sun. I was really happy they had entrepreneurship degree, because it's a fairly new degree in all colleges, but definitely make sure and check to see if they have the degree you want before coming. Going back to diversity, there's not a ton of ethnicity or race diversity. It is a fairly white campus. Although they do promote diversity a lot, I think they're trying to, open their horizons, but it is in the South, and Tennessee is a fairly white state. I've lived here all my life. I've realized that. So that also plays a part in it, but just something to take into consideration, just walking around campus, being in my classes. So I would just definitely take that into consideration, because I think Belmont's trying to work on it. It's just too bad that they promote it so much and it's not really true yet, but there's a ton of diversity here. So yeah. A thing you may know about if you visited and toured Belmont is something called convos or convocations. So basically this is an added element to your degree that is required that other colleges don't require. So basically you have to have 60 hours of convocations, which are like events. Like I've talked to, some of them I really like, some of them are very boring. So some of them, you know, are like business leaders coming in and talking, or like a business panel, which I find interesting. So I would wanna go to that anyway. And I'm gonna get credit for that towards my convo hours. But basically it is a requirement for graduation. You can't graduate without having to go to these 60 convos. Some of them include chapels, some of them include arts and plays and just basically events. So that is an added 60 hours you're gonna have to dedicate to Belmont that at other schools you would have for your own time, if that makes sense. So just look into that if you're not a person who likes to stay on top of added requirements. We don't have a huge, I wouldn't consider us a sports school, definitely more of a music school. Our basketball teams are awesome. I've only been to a few games, but I know they're really good. And so basketball games you do get that kind of like camaraderie, but we don't have a football team. You can go to Vanderbilt, they're right down the road. But if sports are like really big to you and you really want the Southern school experience, the SEC school experience, then Belmont is just probably not for you because it's just not like that here. We wear sweatshirts to like other colleges. I see a ton of UT sweatshirts or, you know, like Auburn sweatshirts on. So we definitely support like our hometown college teams, I would say, more than we support Belmont teams. But that's just something I've seen personally. But yeah, definitely not like an SEC school type of vibe. One thing I do get asked a lot is Greek life. I'm not in Greek life. My roommate Skylar is in Greek life. And so if you want to see what that experience is like, my roommates have a YouTube video and Skylar did a vlog, like going through the recruitment process and everything. We only have three or four sororities and one fraternity. So I like that because it's not like everyone is in a sorority. You don't have to be in a sorority to feel like you have friends, to feel like you have a community. There's so many other clubs, but honestly, I'm in very few clubs and I still feel like I have a community. I personally think because of how small it is, and you're gonna have a lot of the same faces show up in your classes that you'll see in the CAF, that you'll see just around campus and in your halls. Like, I think it's fairly easy to make friends if you're just open and looking for, you know, friendships and real friendships, then I don't think it's too hard to make friends, even if you're not in a sorority, which I really appreciate. So people in a sorority absolutely love it from what I've heard. But if you're not in a sorority, you're still friends with people who are in the sororities. Girls in different sororities are still best friends. Like, it's not very rigid cut like a lot of big sorority fraternity schools are, where you are only friends with people in your sorority. It's not like that at all, but they still offer Greek life if you're interested. I do also want to say it is a Christian school. I don't know if they have that title anymore, but definitely like the Christian traditional values associated with churches are also like sewn into Belmont. So you do have some like chapels you have to go to and things, but definitely I don't feel like they put faith in your face. There's tons of people, maybe even half, maybe like, I don't know, I can't figure it out because I haven't been here long enough, but I've met a ton of people who aren't Christians, have either no beliefs at all, or like aren't religious at all, or have different religions that go here. And I appreciate that just because I think it makes my faith stronger, and it's good to be surrounded by people who think differently than you. So I've seen a lot of that in my classes, a lot of people just thinking differently, bringing new ideas, new discussions. Sometimes it has gotten heated, but different discussions are always happening in my class, which I really appreciate just because I think it makes you a better person to understand different culture, different religion, different ways of life. So I've seen that to a good extent in my classes. It may just be the classes I'm in, but I'm also in my first year religion class right now, and it's definitely not a class that tries to make you a Christian, tries to make you a Baptist, anything like that. It's more like looking at the Bible like a textbook and figuring out history and like the storylines. And so with my religion class, it has been very factual based and not like trying to convert anyone. Never had that experience so far here at Belmont. So I am thankful for that, but do know it still has those Christian values underlying the college. So yes, okay, that is it for this video. If you guys have any more specific questions, let me know, because I will try to be really up to date in the comments and answering them to the best that I can. I am gonna leave my roommate's YouTube channel below because they have some like Belmont tours, their own opinions of Belmont there, so you can check them out. And yeah, I will talk to you guys in my next video. This one was super long. Okay, anyway, goodbye.